Illustration number 6, calculate the impedance of the given circuit. So first of all, you have to consider this circuit is of which kind. You have to understand it. So here you can see clearly that L and C are connected in a series. So L plus C is having a series connection. And the resistance R is connected parallel to L and C. So with this now I can write down that the Z1 is the impedance for series connection and the Z2, or we can say the inductance of or impedance of this resistance R is itself R. So I can write down the impedance Z1 that is actually the combination of impedance of inductor and impedance of capacitor. Now the value of impedance of inductor and impedance of capacitors are known, but before you move further, you want to find out the resultant impedance, and you can directly apply the series connection formula to the law of finding impedance. Therefore, the resultant impedance is given by capital Z, and now if you see, due to the parallel connection, in above case the multiplication will take place, the impedance of both the components, and at below there will be addition takes place. Now substituting the value of Z1 in this equation is equal to ZL plus ZC into R divided by ZL plus ZC plus R. So in the below case, if we see, it is actually the combination of the actual relation of impedance in the LCR series circuit. And so I am writing in this case, the value of ZL is j omega L. The value of ZC is minus J over omega C, and here not plus will come, there will be multiplication with R. And similar way, I am substituting the values of ZL and ZC in the denominator. So J omega L minus J over omega C plus R, and with this, I can take out J is common from the numerator. Therefore, the resultant impedance Z is equal to J into omega L minus 1 over omega C into R divided by from the first two component, I am taking this J as common. Means these are the components of inductor and capacitor. Plus, in addition with that, the resistance is taking place. Now, if you look at these values, this omega L is the value of magnitude of impedance of Z. So, J into XL, and it is the impedance of inductor, not of Z, minus XC into R divided by J into XL minus XC plus R. Now multiplying the complex numbers in the numerator and the denominator with their complex conjugate. What do you mean by complex conjugate first of all? If you multiply this J by J star, then the result will be 1. then this J star is known as complex conjugate of imaginary number J. So here I am also getting the multiplication, and it is in this way. Therefore, mod Z is equal to, in the above case, J is as it is, XL minus XC into R into the multiplication J star XL minus XC into R, and here the curly bracket is over, divided by J into XL minus XC plus R into the multiplication, the complex conjugate of this I am writing in this way, R minus J into XL minus XC. And here whenever you are writing the magnitude, there is 1 by 2 power come. And now, the simplification of this particular quantity is given in this way. Mod Z is equal to, see here R into R is R square. Here XL minus XC is XL minus XC whole square. And J star, J into J star, that is 1. So it is not necessary to writing that. Here R into R is R square. Here plus XL minus XC, and here also plus XL minus XC. So here there will be also its square value. And don't forget to write down the power of Z. In the above expression, whenever XL is equal to XC, then the impedance is 0. So what is the condition means XL is equal to XC? So it is omega L is equal to 1 over omega C. That means the condition is this. At resonant frequency, whenever this LCR circuit will work, the value of impedance will be 0. And now we will switch on to the illustration number 7, which is very similar to this. Illustration number 7. We have to obtain here the angular frequency, in particular resonance angular frequency for the circuit shown in this figure. So here first of all you analyze the circuit. In this circuit the inductor L and the resistance R are connected in a series. So the combination of L plus R, that is the series connection. And the value of capacitor C is connected in the parallel to L plus R. And also the impedance of the series connection I am giving as Z1 is the impedance of the series connection, means the impedance of inductor L and the impedance of resistance R. So it is ZL plus R. Similarly, the resultant impedance Z is given by now see, these two are in parallel connection, so I can use the law of parallel connection given by Kirchhoff as 1 upon Z is equal to 1 upon Z1 plus 1 over ZC. See, it was not given by Kirchhoff, but it was first application of Kirchhoff's law, and hence I am writing with the help of law of parallel connection in LCR circuit. Now we have the values of Z1. So what was the value of Z1? ZL plus R. But the value of ZL is J omega L plus R plus 1 over ZC means 1 upon the value of ZC is 1 over J omega C. So this J omega C will comes into the numerator is equal to 1 over J omega L plus R plus J omega C. Now here what the value you have taken was minus J over omega C. The value of ZC you were considered as minus J over omega C. But can I write down in this way? Minus J over omega C is equal to J cube into omega C or J cube over omega C, because minus 1 is nothing but J square. And with this, when you simplify 1 over ZC, then the final answer will come into this form, J omega C. Now here, if we more simplify or we multiply and divide the first term on the right hand side by R minus J omega L. So with actually the complex conjugate of this, this is actually 1 over R plus J omega L. Now I am multiplying this as R minus J omega L divided by R minus J omega L plus this J omega C is as it is. There is a printing mistake in your textbook. You should correct it. It is written J omega L, but actually it is J omega C. And therefore, the value of 1 upon Z is equal to R minus J omega L. In the numerator, that will be multiplied with 1. And in the below case, there will be R square minus J square, but minus J square is plus 1. So it is omega square L square plus J omega C. Now I am multiplying this quantity with this LCM. That is equal to R minus J omega L plus J omega C R square plus J omega cube, because omega square into omega is omega cube C L square. And now from these two values I am taking some common, and don't forget to write down this denominator R square plus omega square L square. That is equal to R, now I am taking plus J omega is constant, or only plus J I am taking constant. So inside the bracket, first of all omega C R square will come, plus omega cube C L square is there, and minus omega L is there, and the denominator is as it is. But this is the value of 1 upon Z, and we have to find out the value of impedance in order to find out the resonant angular frequency. Therefore, impedance Z is equal to just inverse the above equation, R square plus omega square L square divided by R plus J into omega C R square plus omega cube C L square minus omega L. And this is the impedance or resultant impedance of the given circuit. But we know that if we compare this equation, then the denominator or the imaginary part in the denominator should be zero for the maximum value of Z. Because the imaginary part is the larger, and so we have to consider it as minimum for maximum value of impedance. And so I am assuming over here that the imaginary coefficient is zero, therefore omega C R square plus omega cube C L square minus omega L, that is equal to zero. And therefore, from the all three terms, I am taking omega as common. So, C R square plus omega square C L square minus L, that is equal to zero. Now, I am arranging the terms in this way. Omega square C L square is equal to L minus C R square. And now I am dividing this equation by CL square. Therefore, omega square is equal to 1 over CL or LC minus R square over L square. And now what you have to do to find out resonance angular frequency? It is very easy. You just square root on both the sides. Then you will get the value of omega. And what should it come? Therefore, omega is equal to under root of 1 over LC minus R square over L square. That is the equation number 1 which is required to find out in this particular illustration. Now we will solve illustration number 8.